Francis was an amazing grace to all of us. An amazing grace on our journey. And just pin down what I'm going to say about Francis. And just something came to mind. It's like Mr. Bravo Constant. Everything he felt the Bravo Constant. And again, simply on the death of your aunt, Kate, of course. All of us are on a journey of life. We all have many gifts to share and to offer. Francis shows how to share them all, how to give them all in life. So let us take a moment to be with our God, asking God to be our strength and hope on our journey. Thank you, God, for this great man and the grace that he gave us all. Let us pray. To you, O Lord, we humbly entrust Francis, so precious in your sight. Take him into your arms and welcome him into paradise, where there will be no sorrow, no weeping nor pain, but the fullness of peace and joy with your Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading will be played by Megan. I invite you now to please be seated.
A reading from the Second Chronicles, chapter 5, verse 13. It was the duty of the trumpeters and singers to make themselves heard in unison in praise and thanksgiving to the Lord. When the song was raised with trumpets and cymbals and other musical instruments in praise to the Lord, for he is good. For his steadfast love endures forever. The house of the Lord was built with the cloud. Amen.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
people were bringing little children to him in order that Jesus might touch them, and the disciples spoke sternly to them. But when Jesus saw this, he was indignant and said to them, "Let the children come to me. Do not stop them, for it is to such as these that the kingdom of God belongs. Truly I tell you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a child will never enter it." Then Jesus took them up in his arms, laid his hands on them, and blessed them. The Gospel of the Lord.
The death of someone we love has, of course, gloom over our lives. And so it has been that way last week, the week ago, Thursday, that we heard the death of Francis. And so this morning we gather in great number to remember our brother and offer support and gratitude, of course, to his family, especially to Sister Margaret and Helen. Brothers John and Anthony, Gerald, Joseph and Angus, his in-laws, nieces, nephews, aunt, and uncle, extended family and friends, and especially those who men. When St. Luke wrote this account of the road to Emmaus, it was not just an interesting resurrection story. He was writing a community like many others, and like today, who had to face the question of death, and with death, the feeling of isolation.
the recognition of Jesus in all people, and the telling of the story. Tell it, share the story. The life of each of us can be broken into a series of stories. It's our story, and it's absolutely unique. And everybody's story deserves to be listened to and taken seriously. For to know a person's story is to understand a person. Francis' story, spiritual story, began in this church on October 18, 1959, when he was brought here for baptism. Father McGavin was the priest. And ironically, my uncle John Paul and his wife Anne were the godparents. Others gathered around the baptism of font to share in Francis' journey of faith. Those gathered may have known, like every parent, that their child was special. Like Mary and Joseph, they knew their son would be a sign of contradiction. And so was Francis, Kevin, and McKinnon. For in a world of division, he held out arms of acceptance. In a world of borders, he saw no lines of division. And in a world of mistrust, he called everyone a friend. And in a world of ambition, he measured us not by the head, but by the heart. And because of this contradiction, we are forced to look at our own lives so that our story can end as happily as Francis, with no regrets, but a light that will continue to dance and sing and play. And so we thank to Gavin and Sandy, for the words of young people today, for really being awesome parents, for knowing Francis, like every person who is made in the image and likeness of God. No barrier, but a home we all know was filled with hospitality, love, and acceptance. So the story of Emmaus, the story of Jesus, was filled with hope and meaning. And even though Jesus' life ended in a violent death, there was that hope. He joined up on the road. And on the road, they failed to recognize him. He encouraged them to talk and to continue to tell the story. And so for them, the disciples, Jesus' death was an end to everything. But having listened, Jesus showed them that his life was not an end. In the breaking of the bread, they recognized him. He was alive. He was walking along the road with them. Well, how we feel to see Jesus on our journey. In the ordinary ways of life. In the life of Francis. At the wake yesterday, it was interesting, like we said, we shared the stories of Francis' life. And as you were going through the different names, and all of a sudden, Dempsey came to mind. How many remember Dempsey? Francis and Dempsey. You know, these things come to our mind, and how wonderful they are on our journey. As I said, someone in Annie Ganesh, relative of Marguerite, said Francis, when they would pull into the house, Riverside, all of a sudden he would come out as a young boy and get behind your car and pretend he was driving. And then just to learn that Chisholm brought him the other day, or a couple of months ago, to the Bravo concert site, and there Francis was able to drive. As he said, even as good as James Bond. So we tell those stories, and we tell those stories because they are part of our journey and our lives. Again, hearing of Francis' death, we reminisce so we can say, like the disciples, weren't not our hearts burning within us? Because Francis knew and taught us about the risen Christ. Perhaps then we can learn something in the breaking of the bread, for we too are challenged by God for a specific purpose. And like Francis, blessed in many ways, like the broken bread, like Francis, like me, like you, we are broken. But on our road, we remember Francis, when he changed our lives to the joy of his life, in playing the harmonica, playing the spoons, and even through the sadness of dying. He loved and embraced everyone. Christ saw well beyond limits and limitations. We thank God for the challenge he offered you and me of looking into our lives. As you and his family learned so much from Francis that he truly was a gentleman. Our challenge in